back to this lesson. I hope I'm the class. I'm going to teach level 4. So the unit of competence is perform food and beverage operations. And our session title today is introduction to food and beverage service. Before I continue, I request the class rep to take the register for those people are present by lifting out the first cup and the red chair, then sit down. And I welcome you to this session because it's our new unit this time whereby we are going to be oriented on how to perform service from the start up to the end, and we are going to do it in three terms. So today we are going to start from the first lesson whereby I am going to give out the importance of acquiring knowledge in food and beverage service, and then briefly I will define terms which are of importance in this lesson, that is food and beverage, such that going forward you can be able to understand and use them properly as it's expected in the industry practices. So I'm going to give you importance of studying this unit, how it's going to help you once you are through with your studies in this college. The first one, this unit is going to assist you to know how organization structure of various establishments operates in, that is on our ground, on what we call organizational structure. This unit, we're going to know how organizations have different structures depending, we can be able to have vertical and horizontal structures depending on the type of the establishment. The second importance of studying this unit, we're going to understand the various skills that you can be able to use as a waiter. Remember, you are going to do a professional service to people who are knowledgeable more than you most of the times, and you need to understand various skills that you are going to employ while serving food and beverage to your esteemed clients who are patronized your establishment. Another importance of studying this unit, you can be able to acquaint yourself with the skills that are supposed to deal with customer care. Remember, this is an hospitality industry, and generally we are expected to be hospitable to the clients that patronize your place. Regardless of its status in the society, we are supposed to treat each client the way it is supposed to be done by adhering to the customer care skills that you are going to acquire after studying this unit. Another importance of studying this unit is that you are going to know how operations are being carried out in an hotel or an hospitality enterprise. You are going to know how services are being offered in an operation, that is, since morning up to the evening hours. We are supposed to know the opening or what we call operating hours of most of these establishments, so we will be able to advise the clients appropriately. Maybe the final because of having this unit, we will be able to understand the safety measures that are in place in my establishment, such as we will be able to advise the clients appropriately, even your fellow colleagues, on how they can be able to give and maintain maximum safety while doing the work that they have been assigned by the superiors or people who are in charge of operations. So, class, those are some of the significance of studying this unit of Unit of Competence of Perform Food and Beverage Operations, which is a level 4 under CPET curriculum. So, to start with, we are going to define terms as they are used in hospital industry and as far as this unit is concerned. So from this title, we can be able to see that we have food, we have beverage, we have operations. So I want to start with defining the first term, which is food. Class, what do you understand by the term food?
Okay, can I tell you this? Anything that is edible, either in form of liquid or solid. Anything edible in form of liquid or solid.
What are them? Another one?
It is anything that when consumed provides the body with the nutrients.
Thanks. Food is any substance which is edible. It can be solid or liquid, and once it has been consumed by a person, it provides an individual with the most 3 benefits. The first benefit of food when a person consumes is that it provides energy to the body. Another one, it provides immune, or it boosts immune system. Another one, it repairs worn out tissues in the body. So those are the 3 most significance of taking food. And we can give me an example of an energy providing food.
Banana.
That's green banana. Make an example of a vitamins which boosts immune system. We have fruits. An example of a protein that assists the body to repair the worn out tissues. So that's the first term, food, that is edible and has these three functions. But I'm going to look at the second term, which is beverage. I think in your daily life, this sort of schooling of come across the term beverage. Who can be able to give us a meaning of the term beverage? Any attempt? What is a beverage? Yes, anyone?
I can say it is an edible drink.
What attempt? How about? Yes.
She
beverage is a drink which can be non-alcoholic or alcohol content, which is consumed by a person. Then we have another definition that we are supposed to deal with today is service. As far as we are able to see that we are dealing with the first three terms. What do you understand by the term service?
I think service is fulfilling the needs of the
individual. That is a good answer. Service is the act of filling the needs, wants, and desires of the guest. And usually, when the partner is your area, you are supposed to ensure that you provide the needs of the customers in the right way. I think for today, we are going to stop at point, and next time we are going to start with the attributes of a good food and beverage personnel. But before I conclude, I'd like to see whether we have understood these three important terms as used in food and beverage service. Can you be able to give us a summary of what is a food? Who can be able to define what is food? I think because of time, those other terms will be able to refer them in your notes. Have a nice afternoon and I'll see you next week. God willing.